Hello students, I am Mr. Sandeep here. In our subject Advanced Manufacturing Processes, today we are going to discuss on various processes that is based on another energy, that is thermal energy involved. So in the first session we have discussed the unconventional machining processes concept. So based on different types of energy involved, we can classify different processes. So based on mechanical energy, we have discussed the abrasive jet machining and also ultrasonic machining, right? So in previous session we have discussed the chemical energy based process, that is electrochemical machining, right? So today we are going to discuss on the processes that is based on the energy, thermal energy. So based on the thermal energy involved, we can classify the unconventional machining processes. So first one is electron beam machining, then laser beam machining, and also plasma arc machining, right? So let us start our discussion on various processes that is based on thermal energy involved. So as per our discussion, plasma arc machining, short form is PAM, laser beam machining, that is very popular process in unconventional category, and that is denoted by LBM, that is laser beam machining, and also electron beam machining process, that is EBM in short form. So these processes are under category of thermal energy involved. It means here material will be removed based on heat energy generation or say thermal energy generation. So one thing is very clear, here our principle will be based on thermal or heat energy. It means due to high temperature, material can be removed. So this is the principle of material removal for all the processes under category of thermal energy involved. So in today's session, let us start our discussion on electron beam machining, that is one of the processes under category of thermal energy involved. So here, as per the name, electron beam machining, here beam of electron is generated, and with help of this focused or concentrated beam, we can generate the heat, and the same heat will be utilized for melting of your material, and we can remove or cut the material. That is our final purpose. So the process is electron beam machining, and the short form is EBM, and as per our discussion, this process is based on thermal energy involved. So here, once again I repeat, beam of electron is generated. So just remember one thing here, electron generation is very important. So light speed or say speed of the light is around 3 into 10 raised to 8, that is 3 multiplied by 10 power 8 meter per second. So here half of this light speed generally, so at the speed, half of the light speed, our electron beam is strike or say electron beam is accelerated towards the workpiece, and at this high velocity, the beam is striked at our workpiece and heat is generated, right? So at the half of the light speed, we can accelerate our electron beam, and that is concentrated by some sort of mechanism at our workpiece end, and we can remove or cut or melt or in simple word vaporize our workpiece due to this high heat generated, right? So this high velocity electron beam can generate the heat. This is very simple principle that I want to explain you, right? So let's have a look on construction and working of this electron beam machining. So as per our discussion here, electron beam must be generated. So for this electron beam generation, electron gun setup is used, right? So electron gun setup is used here, diaphragm is also used, yes, here focusing lens is also mentioned here, right? So in the construction, our first or say our main purpose is to generate the electron beam, right, and guide the electron beam to the final workpiece end, right? So one thing is very important here, for perfect or for efficient machining, vacuum chamber is must. because mass of the electron is very, very negligible or so very less. So we have to provide the vacuum in surrounding of this whole setup. In other words, vacuum chamber is must for this machining and for efficient cutting of your workpiece. Right. So here I mentioned the general construction details, that is electron gun, diaphragm, focusing lens is also there, and your work is stable. Also fixer mechanism is also there. Right. So vacuum chamber is also necessary, or say vacuum chamber is required for this setup. So here, as per our discussion, here I mentioned the electron gun details. So electron beam is generated with help of electron gun. So inside the electron gun or electron gun setup is having a tungsten filament, right? So tungsten is very important material. So when you provide the power supply, that is a high voltage supply, what happens? Your tungsten filament will be heated. So at the elevated temperature of around 2500 or say 2000 to 3000 degrees Celsius, what happens? Electrons are generated from the tungsten filament. So here, generally tungsten filament is connected with the cathode of your high power supply, or say high potential difference, right? So it is connected with the negative power supply. So here anode is also provided. So what is the purpose of anode? With help of anode, we can accelerate the electron beam towards the downward direction, that is our workpiece direction. So our purpose is to accelerate the beam of electron towards the workpiece, right? So tungsten filament is heated, and due to this, what happens? Electron beam is generated, and here focusing lens is provided. So the beam will be accelerated in downward direction. With help of diaphragm, you can control the beam, and also with help of focusing lens, you can focus the concentrated or say convergent beam on the workpiece, right? So this is how our electron beam can be accelerated and strike at the workpiece. So here I mentioned the construction setup for the electron beam machining, right? So here electron beam is generated with help of our gun as per our discussion. So anode is also mentioned in this image, focusing lens is also there, diaphragm is also there, and cathode and anode power supply is also mentioned here, right? So our purpose is to generate the heat and melt the workpiece, right? So here I mentioned the working steps that are very important. So as per our discussion, when we connect the DC power supply, that is elevated voltage, what happens? Our tungsten filament will be heated at around 2000 to 3000 degrees Celsius. So due to this high temperature, electrons are emitted and accelerated in downward direction with help of anode, because anode is connected with the different supply. It means our tungsten filament will be connected with the cathode, and anode is also provided. So due to this different polarity, our electron beam will be accelerated in downward direction. So here, as per our discussion, vacuum must be provided. So generally 760 mm of mercury is the atmospheric pressure as per the general pressure system. It means 760 mm of mercury is nothing but it is our atmospheric pressure. So here 10 raised to minus 5 to 10 raised to minus 6 mm of mercury vacuum is provided, right? So it is a one notation, or say it is a digit, how much vacuum we can provide for our electron beam machining setup, right? So in terms of mm of Hg, we can specify, or say mm of mercury, we can specify the vacuum, or say amount of vacuum provided. So vacuum pump is necessary for continuous vacuum generation, right? So due to small leakage, we have to provide, or say we have to continuously provide the vacuum pumping to our setup, right? So this is how we can generate the vacuum. So here I mentioned the working steps for the same. So for high pulse, what happens? Due to this high pulse of the electron beam, high heat or high temperature will be generated at the workpiece end, and our metal can be melted or metal can be cut. So this is how electron beam machining can be done, right? So here I mentioned the various advantages for this process, right? So as per our discussion, this process is very useful for any complex machining, right? So here I mentioned the main advantages. So here we can make the hole. It means the drilling is one of the operations that we can easily go, or say we can choose this process for the drilling process, or say drilling machining setup, right? So for the drilling, we can use this process very efficiently, right? So here heat affected zone is very less. It means we can focus our electron beam in that particular small area, and heat will not be, or say our zone will not be affected with help of heat. So this process is having a very small heat affected zone. So this process can be automated easily. So here we can do the machining with help of some automation, right? So this is how electron beam machining can be useful. So at the same time, here I mentioned the various limitations for the setup. So first and most important thing is vacuum generation. So maintain the vacuum is not an easy task. So here you have to maintain the vacuum, or continuously a vacuum for the setup. It means it is very difficult, or say it is a costly thing, right? So the initial costing of the setup is also higher, and here also the skill labor, or say here labor will be having a high skill. So it is required for high skill labor for the setting of the parameter, right? So here I mentioned the various points that we have to consider before choosing the electron beam machining, right? So here your material removal rate will be comparatively low, right? So this process is comparatively slow. It means material removal rate is low, so you can drill the small holes, but for larger dimensions you cannot go for this process efficiently, right? So here I mentioned the various applications. So as per our discussion, drilling is one of the operations that we can perform on electron beam machining. So here I mentioned the various areas of application. So for the turbine blades, for the aerospace industries, we can choose this process efficiently, right? So here I mentioned the various points regarding the application, or say main applications of this setup, right? So for any embedded circuits, or say electronic circuit, we can also choose the electron beam machining, right? So this is all about the electron beam machining, that is process under category of thermal energy involved. Thank you all of you.